This is from Genesis 11, okay? When God made Adam and Eve, he told them to have many children and fill the earth, and they did. After the flood, Noah's three sons began having children and grandchildren. As the number of people on earth began to grow, again, God told Noah's family to spread out and start to cover the earth. God created this big, wide world, and he wanted humans to care for all the land, not just one big city. He wanted them to help one another and to remind one another of his great promise to send his son to save us from our sins.
Yeah, good job. How about this one?
What's your o'clock first?
8:25.
Yeah, Parker, you're doing good.
I'm just not good doing it for Roman numerals. 10 o'clock.
Yeah, okay. What about this one?
Babe, I am digging the look. Where are you going?
What?
Joe, I love it. I mean, the kneecaps are showing, the camo beanie. Joe, you got it going on, babe.
And welcome back to the channel. Joe's out here working outside, just trying to clean up the property a little bit. We finally got those two sheds cleaned out. I say we, it was actually Joe. I was still kind of recovering from my episode, if you guys watched my last video. But those sheds were packed full. Remember when our household goods were delivered? We don't have a garage. So all of the garage equipment, everything that didn't have a place went into those two sheds. Joe finally got those completely cleaned out and organized. So we're just getting all these boxes burnt and kind of cleaning up the property a little bit. So today we're actually gonna take you guys with us. We're gonna go up to a beautiful, quaint little town here in Alaska called Talkeetna. And it's interesting because we actually almost bought a cabin in Talkeetna, a couple of them that we looked at up there, also in the Trapper Creek area. The only reason we didn't is the cabins that we looked at were a little too run down. And Joe and I have bought and sold several homes, and we knew we wanted to build up a homestead, but the cabin, the home itself, we didn't want to have to do all kinds of upgrades and stuff to make it safe. So we opted not to go with those cabins and pick this property that we're in instead. But nonetheless, Talkeetna is an adorable touristy town in the summertime. So we're gonna go up there and check it out today for the first time, walk through the shops, let Parker check it out, and we thought it'd be fun to take you guys with us. Do you know what the temperature is today?
12 when we get up.
It's cold, 12 degrees.
What brand?
So this is how we deal with most of our trash. Oh, it's much warmer facing this way, Joe. The stuff that we can't burn, we take to the local landfill, but most of it we can burn right here, so it makes it easy.
Talking about my attire.
I like your attire, Joe. I like this, you know, scruffy mountain man, don't care what I'm wearing look on you. I even love your snotsicles. Yeah. You know that? So I have a question for you, Joe. Okay, we are not that close. What do you have to say when people say that I talk to you like I'm a drill sergeant? I'm just curious. Like, do you feel...
I just say, yes, drill sergeant.
You better sound off, soldier. I say to those people, they just don't know us. They don't know our marriage. We've been married for what? Almost 24 years. It'll be this year, babe. 2023 will be 24 years. So, that long, babe. Joe and I, like, completely get off on picking on each other.
Don't say that.
I said that, and I don't really care. That's what we do. That's how we keep it fun. That's how we keep it exciting. Anybody that's been married long enough knows, like, you can't be serious all the time. Lighten up. Have fun. So, people think that I talk to you like I'm a drill sergeant. And, of course, I say your name too much. So, from here on out, 2023... I'm no longer saying Joe.
Oh, okay.
That's my goal for 2023. No longer allowed to say Joe. I'm going to say babe, honey buns, sugar plum fairy, tootsie, schnookums. That's it, Joe. Ah, dang it. I said it. All right. Well, I better get back in the house and help Parker finish school. We're done with math, heading into language arts. He just has a little, almost like a quiz in language arts today too, so it should be pretty quick. And then we're gonna get ready and head up to Talkeetna. Let me show you guys my new front door. I haven't shown you yet. Dun da da! Look at that. Isn't that cute? Yes, airtight and cute. So we're gonna paint it, but not right now, it's too cold to paint. But I love this little window right here. Joe put it in this week, and I love it.
Mom.
All right, what now?
What are synonyms?
Okay, so synonyms, remember we talked about synonyms and antonyms, right? So synonyms are words that are the same, and antonyms are words that are opposite. So if it's saying write at least two synonyms and one antonym for the word humble.
That means poor, right?
No, humble does not mean poor. Humble, how do I explain it?
Like you're a bum on the road?
No, it has nothing to do with poverty or poorness at all. Being humble is kind of being gracious. You're being humble about something. So, for example, all the Christmas cards we got this year and the gifts from our YouTube family, right? Mm-hmm. I was very humbled by that. Like, I'm grateful. I'm gracious. I'm not arrogant and cocky. I don't think people owe me anything. It's being humble about things, right?
So humble is being nice. That's what that
means. Oh, yeah, being nice. So let's ask Siri. Hey, Siri, what does humble mean? Let's see what Siri has to say.
As an adjective, humble means having or showing a modest or low estimate of one's own importance. Do you want to hear the next one?
No, thank you. So, humble, having or showing a modest or low estimate of one's importance. So it's not all about me. It's not all about Parker.
So it's kind of like the golden rule.
The golden rule being unselfish, not putting yourself first, putting others first. Does that make sense?
Mm-hmm. Okay. I'm going to give a shout out to one of our subscribers. Her name is Lori. You guys, we got so many gifts and cards from you, and my personality, I'm the type of person, like, I want to be able to thank everybody and call everybody out, and like, there was just so many, and I had so many people message me like, did you get my gift? And I'm like, what's your name? I need your name, because I can remember the names on the packages, but I can't. There was a lot, and I'm so humbled and so grateful. But Lori, she made us some homemade gifts, and I just cannot believe the love and energy and time that went into them. One, she messaged me and said, you know, can I make you a curtain for your laundry room area? You guys, I have to show you this. So first of all, she made me two of them, which is awesome because when one is washing, I can put the other one on. And I asked her to please pick the pattern. I told her I love neutral colors, rustic, country, cabin-y, whatever. And I asked her to pick out the pattern for me, and she did not disappoint. She made me and Parker the most beautiful, sweetest gifts. And I just want to show them to you guys really quick. And I want to thank you, Lori. You're very talented and they're very special to our family. All right, so you guys know our washer and dryer is back here in this little space under the stairs, right? And we didn't have a curtain or anything. So Lori, look at this. She made this adorable little curtain to cover our laundry area. And I love it. It's country, look. Live, love, lodge. Absolutely love it. And then the other one is also cabin themed. This one here, super cute, right? It's kind of a darker pattern, but it's still all very country, cozy, cabin-y. And I just love it. Look at this little pillow. It's all about love. And she took photos, I'm guessing, off my Instagram and sewed them onto the pillow. There's Bradley and Gunner, Parker and Dad catching their first grouse. That was Thanksgiving Day. Family, Faith, and dogs. And then the back matches the curtain fabric. Super cute. And then she made Parker, well, she got him this little moose. I don't think she made the moose. Lori, you can let me know if I'm wrong, but she made him this cute little outfit. Look, a little scarf to go with it, a little beanie. And then didn't she sew your name too, Parker?
Yeah, Parker's pal.
Parker's pal, look at
and
that.
His name is Coco.
And his name is Coco. So cute.
He looks like a Coco.
He does look like a Coco. You want to show your blanket that she made too?
Yeah.
So this little shark blanket, and then she sewed Parker's name on this too. Right over here.
Parker 2022.
Merry Christmas, Parker 2022. So cute. Oh, it's not sharks, Parker, it's airplanes.
Yeah.
My bad, I thought it was sharks.
And look at the other side too.
It's super cute. Yes, I love it. You wanna say thanks to Lori?
Thank you. More than three.
Yeah, super lative is comparing more than three.
And most high.
Well, most high or how else could you say that?
Highest.
Highest, right. California recorded the highest temperature. Good job.
L-O-P-E.
Okay. That is almost correct. There's one letter, antelope.
E.
E. Very good. Not an I.
L-P-H-A-N-T.
Very good, Parker. I had the most interesting comment yesterday. All right, so just an update. Before we left Virginia, when we had like 40, 50,000 subscribers, I was still able to reply to everybody. Emails, Facebook, Instagram messages, YouTube comments, whatever it was, I was still able to keep up with them. Since we got to Alaska, we have hit 70 something thousand subscribers. Whoa, whoa. I can't keep up. I can't keep up. Even when Joe helped me with the YouTube comments, I can't keep up. So it's like,
I haven't done them in a while.
I know, and even Joe's getting behind. So y'all, if we don't reply to you right away, please don't take it personal. Like, we are just one little family. We don't have staff or employees that work for us, like a lot of like the million-dollar YouTubers or like famous bloggers and stuff. We don't. It's just me and Joe. Just me and Joe. So I do, and a lot of times it's late when I get back to you and it's not intentional. I'm just working through all of them, trying to get to them. But anyway, last night I got through all my Facebook messages after a while. Somebody, Mr. Rudy Pants, said that he's a psych major, and I have, what did he say?
I have multiple personalities.
I have mental health issues, and I've got multiple personalities, and that I really need help. And he said that they study me in their psych class. They pull up my videos and watch me. Hi, class. So since you've met Tina, I wanted to introduce you to someone very special and close to my heart.
Elsa.
Her name is Candy. Candy, say hi to the psych class. Hello. That's Candy. You never met her yet, have you? There's lots more where that came from. Now, Candy is an interesting person. She's actually married to Bill. Bill's here with us too. Bill, you want to come on in?
Hey, how you doing? My name's Bill. Well, it's really Billy Bob, but I go by Bill or Billy, whichever one you choose. Me and Candy, we've been married about 27 years now, and she's really special.
See, so said my sweet friend on Facebook Messenger, you know, anytime I can help you guys out with your studies, you just let me know. I will bring the whole freaking gang. No problem. We can have a party. Hey, Schnookum Pants. Do you have any friends hiding inside of you?
Just Josephina.
Josephina, that's right. She helped us decorate the Christmas tree this year. How could I forget Josephina? So comments like that, I just delete them. I don't even reply to them. It's just the most ridiculous thing ever, right? But I did want to address something. And I know a lot of you, I love you. And you tell me, Tina, don't reply to these haters. Don't give them your time. One person said they watched another YouTuber that got so overwhelmed with the hateful comments, they quit doing YouTube. Let me tell you guys something. My mama raised a stubborn girl. They ain't gonna scare me away. If anything, it makes me wanna do YouTube even more. And I don't call them out sometimes in my videos to give them spotlight on my channel. I do it because it makes me feel better. And honestly, some of the things that are brought up, I figure if some people think that, wonder that, feel that, question that, there might be others. And so some of it I legitimately want to address. One of them is this. I've actually had a couple people, just two, very special people. You know, when I do my morning reading with Parker, when we start homeschool, we do our devotions. Parker likes to sit at the table with like his little dinosaurs or whatever, and he likes to play with his toys quietly while I read our daily devotion and I read our scripture reading for the day. These people have messaged me and they're like, your son is not even listening to you. He's sitting there playing with his toys. You should make him stop playing with his toys because he's not even listening to you. And it's like, I wonder if these people even have children, first of all, because obviously, you don't. If you think you can make your kids sit there straight as an arrow and not move while you read Bible scriptures and a devotional, you must be confused, or you must have some super awesome children, like superpower children that can just sit still that long. My son is not that. And that's part of why we homeschool, you guys, is to be able to do things the way that we want to do it, not the way that people tell us we have to do it or the way people think it's supposed to be done because all they know is the public school setting, right? Parker does so much better with listening when his hands are busy. I know my son, I know his learning style, his personality, and he actually listens better when his hands are busy. And it's really similar to listening to a podcast while I do dishes, or do you listen to the radio or your favorite podcast when you're driving, right? So you can multitask, and some people retain more and listen better when their hands are busy and they're not being made to sit straight as a board, right? So I just want to say that, like, if you've ever watched our videos and you see Parker playing with his little toys while we're reading in the morning, I allow that. He actually runs upstairs and gets a couple Legos or some toys that he can play with while we do our reading. It keeps him busy, keeps him out of trouble, keeps him at the table and engaged while we're reading our Bible reading in the morning. And he retains it. And we have discussions every day about the scripture that we read. So I know that he's listening because of these discussions.
Closer than before, and no one knows
What a super cute town Talkeetna is, right? That was a lot of fun. Now, that was nothing compared to the summertime. There's actually only a few shops open and two little restaurants that I saw. One was the pub that we went to, and then another one was a little pizza shop. But in the summertime, it is just all bets are off. It's tourist season and it's super busy. So I'm kind of glad that we got our first taste of Talkeetna during the off season. I was gonna show you guys what I got at the little store. So I got myself a cute little hoodie. This one doesn't have an actual hood to it, so I kind of like that. But it still has the high neck to keep my neck warm. Super cute. I'm all about hoodies, leggings and hoodies. And then I got this really cute ceramic dish. I'm gonna use this for my earrings and my rings. Like in the bathroom, I can take my ring off at night and my earrings and just set them in here. Very pretty. And then of course you guys know I got me a new coffee cup. Talkeetna, isn't that cute? Don't tell Lexi. She thinks I'm a coffee cup hoarder.
You are.
Parker said I am. And then I got some chaga extract. You guys may have heard of this. Chaga is a natural fungus that grows on trees here in Alaska. I don't know if it grows anywhere else, but it does grow here in Alaska. And it has a lot of antioxidants and it's just supposed to have a lot of healing benefits for your body. So I'm gonna start putting a little bit of this in my coffee in the mornings. And then look what I found. Alaska sourdough recipes. I am really excited about this. You guys know I love my sourdough starter. I love making breads and stuff. So this kind of has just all kinds of fun recipes. I was looking at it in the store and it actually looks like easy recipes. A lot of sourdough recipes that I see online are just super complicated. And I think that's what scares people away from sourdough. But look at these, like sourdough English muffins. This is it right here. This is how to make it. It's not like 3 pages of instructions. Is it dinner time?
Stay.
They're like, Dad, we're ready.
There we go. Sit. Sit. Yeah.
Come on.
super cute. It's got these little ties down here. You guys can see those. It's got those little ties. And little ties up here. I like it. Super cute. What about some comfy hoodies and leggings? Yes.
So I showed you guys on Instagram Christmas, if you're watching my Christmas stories. Oh, the dogs. Joe bought me a lighted mirror, and I was super excited. I saw this mirror, and at the time they were out of stock, and so I didn't think I was gonna get it. So the lighting in the bathroom, there's just one light, and it's overhead. So for a girl, when you're doing your makeup, it makes it really hard, especially because the light is over by the shower. It's nowhere near the mirror where I'm doing my makeup. And you know, for us ladies that have the eyebrow drama, we need some special lighting for that. So anyway, I saw this lighted mirror, LED, so it'll be fine with the solar. Joe surprised me. He went and ordered it at some point when I didn't know about it and picked it up when I didn't know about it and surprised me on Christmas. So I think he's gonna install it for me tonight.
Well, fancy meeting y'all here again. Hi. This is actually the mirror. Look at that. So these are like, it's lighted. It's LED. You can switch it and dim it and make it brighter. Super cool. I cannot wait to install this bad boy. Find a stud?
Yeah, it's on the wrong side. Oh, I wonder. I'd be able to just pull the whole thing out.
So I think what we're going to be doing is actually hardwiring this into the wall. You can plug it into the wall, but that's going to be like a big old plug coming out of the wall. So I think he's trying to hardwire it into the wall so that you don't see the wires anywhere, which would be nice.
I like to see your brain work when you're trying to troubleshoot, figure things out.
Yeah. Can you? Just gonna get a lamp.
Oh, you had to go through the stud.
Yeah.
I see why you did that now, Joe. Nice little hole there.
Mm-hmm. Did you miss me today? Aw. Did you miss me? I missed you too. Were you a good boy? Yeah, were you a good boy? Yeah, did you miss your mama? Did you miss your mama?
Gunner, come.
Oh, Gunner. You're bigger than Bradley, I think. Yes. Yes, you are. Handsome babies. Handsome babies. You want me to kiss?
What's it get stuck on? Oh, I see. Oh, there it goes. I got it. Huh? Keep pulling it. You got that mirror.
Alright.
Oh, so you just put the wood in there so you had something to drill the drywall back to? Smart, Joe.
Thank you.
All right, guys, there it is. Look at that. Woo woo. How nice is that? So it's got this little button here. You can make it different colors so you turn it off. I think I like that one. Really nice. So the only light I had before was this one, way over by the shower. So whenever I would do my makeup, it would cast a shadow on my face, and you know, this just kind of brightens up the whole thing. So it's kind of nice. Tubes & Co. skincare. You guys know I love my Tubes & Co. You guys haven't checked out my Tubes & Co. link. Organic natural skincare. Check out the video description. Tallow balm, glow serum, and my sea buckthorn cleansing oil. That's all I use every day on my face, in my neck, in my chest. And occasionally I use my tallow balm on my body as a moisturizer and as a lip balm. I love, 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 love my Tubes & Co. Check out that link. And I even have a coupon code in the video description for 10% off your entire order. So check it out. And then I don't think I even showed you guys, we finally got the bathroom vanity in. Totally forgot to show you guys that. Remember the old one that we used to have? With the big old bowl sitting on top of the counter. So you have like no room for anything. Finally took that bad boy out. Put this new one in.
All right, guys, it is the next day. I just got home from my physical therapy appointment. We have a big mess to deal with. I told you guys this on my last video. Like, all this stuff, look, it, yeah, Christmas has to go. It's time.
You look at me like I'm crazy when I shut my feelings out. You look at me like I'm different. Still you stay cause you feel something real. Get so lost in my moments. Doesn't mean I don't need you. I fell in love with your colors. They kinda tell me what I'm thinking. I fell in love with the way we are and the way we lose it. There's something different about us and the reason why we stay. We fly around like paper planes. They never know where we will fall. Nobody can see us. Still they wanna tear us apart. There's something different about the way we are. Cup after cup, yeah, it's just the way we do it. Anything just to block out the real life, real life. Yeah, we're loving the way they think we're so messed up, up. Even if what we're doing is bad, there's so many emotions. Sharing stories that we never had. The end is real. I think we're searching for reasons not to be like them. We fly around like paper planes. They never know where we will fall. Nobody can see us. Still they wanna tear us apart. There's something different about the way we are. Ooh. different by the way we are. There's something different by the way we are. About to leave, already packing. Come with me, I'm not really asking. We'll get away to a place where we don't know. About to see the world in action. What we can be, life with no distractions. We'll get away, this is what we waited for. Take my hand, we'll make it somehow. We can't miss out. I'm done living life with the lights out. Die with my own doubts. Be free with me. Be free. Be free with me. Looking back, eyes on the freeway, Bonnie and Clyde, a classic cliche. We're on the run, this is what we waited for. Take my hand, we'll make it somehow. We can't miss out. I'm done living life with the lights out.
And in the trapper keep trap. I was gonna say something else. What was I gonna say? What were you talking about?
No, seriously, this. Am I drunk? I'm drunk. Okay. Let's try that again. Park, you don't have a shirt on. I will not show your nipples on YouTube.
Okay.
Are you trying to do that with your butt? Babe, stop flexing your butt. What are you doing? Okay. Really? You threw firecrackers in there?